He is number 80. He is the man. He is Donald Driver, wide receiver on the Green Bay Packers. Donald, good to have you back.
Hello, family. How you all doing?
Fantastic. Excellent. It's good to hear you. Hey, I want to start out by reading you a quote from one of your buddies. Defensive end C.J. Wilson said this just today. The man, Donald Driver, is a legend. I see him lifting weights that a D lineman should be doing. I'm telling you, the man is strong. He's definitely a leader on this team. We all believe in him on and off the field. Just glad he's a part of us. No way he gets cut. You're a lock to make this team when camp breaks, aren't you?
Well, I hope so. I mean, that's always been my goal, to play as long as I can. You know, my thing was to come in this season and prove a lot of people wrong. You know, there's a lot of people that was doubting that I was going to even be able to hold up in training camp. So I think I've done my the best I can do. I've proven that I can play with the best of them. So I'm hoping that at the end of the day, I'm hoping that I'm still a Packer.
Donald, this was your 14th training camp, I think. So when you think back to the beginning, who was a guy that maybe kind of helped the transition for you and maybe influenced the way that you work with some of the younger receivers?
Well, I think for me, it was just totally different than it was back then. You know, I think one thing that Antonio Freeman and Robert Brooks, they did is they did it real fast. They took me under their wing, and they told me that, you know, you can't control numbers. You know, you just got to go out there and play. And let your play dictate what's going to happen. And that's what I did. And that's kind of how, you know, I've done it for 14 seasons. In that, you know, you can't start counting numbers anymore. You just got to go out there and play and hope that at the end of the day, you're on the team.
Now, you say things are totally different back then than they are now. How are things different?
Well, I mean, I think the thing is that you have to, you don't see the guys, I mean, totally different than what you see now. You know, these guys now are constantly trying to support and take guys on their wing and help guys out because it's not about, you know, oh, he's trying to take my spot. Well, back then, everybody wanted their job, so it wasn't about helping as much as possible. These guys are now helping. To make sure guys get better and better to win games.
What exactly does a seasoned player do during the fourth preseason game when you go out for about a snap?
You say that again?
I said, what does a seasoned player do during the fourth preseason game when you maybe will play a snap or two? How do you pass the time on the sidelines?
You watch the young guys. You cheer the young guys on, and you try to help them in every situation that may come up. So I think that's the biggest thing. You enjoy the game. You know, I enjoy football. I enjoy the game all the way. So, I mean, even when I'm not playing, I love to see the young guys shine. So, I mean, we already talked to the young guys that this is a great opportunity for them. They're going to play more than they probably expected, but this is it. This is the final straw.
Has anyone asked you to see the mirror ball yet, the trophy?
Everyone thinks I carry the mirror ball with me all the time. So, you know, even when I'm at practice, they go, Don, where's the mirror ball, you know? Show us the mirror ball. I'm like, I don't have the mirror ball. The mirror ball is at home, where it should be. So, but it's been truly blessed. I'm glad I had the opportunity to do it. I'm glad that ABC gave me opportunity and Dancing Stars gave me opportunity to be on that show.
Where is the mirror ball, Donald?
The mirror ball is at home. The mirror ball is at home, right here in Green Bay. So,
on display for everybody to see. If I walk into your house, is there like a all your old trophies
above the fireplace?
The fireplace on the mantle.
You know, no, you know, Trina, you walk in, you gotta make some turns and cuts to be able to see it. But it's there. It's out. I have it in a little safe box right now, you know, because my kids like to play with it. They like to show their friends, and everyone that comes over, they like to take it out and show them. So I've been putting it up so they won't, the kids won't break it.
So, Donald, are we going to see PETA up at a game this
fall?
Yes.
Well, we was trying to get her to the first game, and that's what I'm still trying to do to get her come up next week. But she's not sure because they had already started dancing. So I don't want her to take her away from what she's trying to do, and that's win another title.
A warm weather game. Get her to a warm weather game so she's not all bundled up looking like a hunter when she's up there.
Well, you know, I think the season ends at sometime. If she keeps going, then she may, you know, be there until the end of November. So I have to bring her for a cold game. I'll put in a she'll be in the box with Tina and the kids, so she'll be okay.
Now, have they announced the new cast for this next Dancing with the Stars? And if they have, do you have a favorite?
Oh yeah, I mean, you know, I'm pulling for my old partner. I'm pulling for PETA. PETA and Gil is dancing together. So, Gil, he finished second last a couple of years ago, season 8 with Cheryl Burke. So I'm pulling for him. He's a great dancer. I've watched him dance over the years. So. He's a great, I guess you could say, a great dancer, great actor. All of it runs in one. But I think Peter's going to be able to to win that title again. There's a lot of great people on this show. I mean, Sean Johnson is back. Emmitt Smith is back. So it's going to be tough to see what happens.
He and, is Donald Driver.
I was going to say, Emmitt can't hold a candle to you, can he, Donald?
No.
No.
No,
no, I think that was a fine example. I mean, during the show, he told me, Donald, no, and the next athlete you get on this show is going to have to do something totally amazing because you set the bar too high.
I think I
set the bar pretty good for Packers fans, so we're good.
I think you're absolutely right. He is Donald Driver. You can hear him every week here at 3:20 on WTMJ on Tuesdays. Donald, stay healthy and go get him.
I will. Thank you all so much. Appreciate it.